of love and togetherness that this season brings.
So, get ready for a magical journey filled with joy, laughter, and the spirit of the season. From carols that will warm your hearts to dance numbers that will dazzle, we've got it all.
To initiate today's program, recognizing that the power of prayer does not come from the words we say, but from the one who hears them. I would now like to request Rupchi Kaur from class 9A to come and lead us in prayer.
Good morning, everyone. Let us close our eyes and bow down our heads in prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for this beautiful day that You have given us. Thank You for Your goodness and blessing over us. By sending Your Son as a baby to this world, You have given us eternal life. We thank Thee for the love, joy, and peace this season brings in. Be with everyone present here and bless us with Your presence. Guide us and lead us. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Bhakti.
Psalm 119, verse 105 beautifully declares, Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. I would now like to request Arun Major of Class 9C to lead us in reading from the Word of God.
Today's Bible reading is taken from three different portions. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 15. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. The second reading is taken from John chapter 3, verses 15 to 18, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world, that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. He who believes in Him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. The third reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. May the hearing and the reading of his word be blessed. Thank you.
Thank you, Ara, for reading the scripture portion. Music gives a soul to the universe, wings to the mind. Music gives color to the air of the moment. Our first performers are incredibly talented and are here to serenade us with their beautiful voices. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming the primary school choir. They will be gracing us with a beautiful medley of Christmas carols. Let's give them a warm welcome as they take the stage.
Let's go.
Celebration, join in all the fun. Share a jubilation.
Fantastic singers for that outstanding start to our Christmas celebration.
Continuing with our spectacular 60th diamond celebration, I would now like to call upon Pranjal Arora and Amar Das of Class 9B to come on stage to take us through this special occasion through an inspiring presentation and captivating speech.
Ideas are with everyone, but only some can make it true.
Vision is with everyone, but only some can guide the way through.
A pleasant
good morning to one and all present here.
I, Pranjal Arora of Class 9C,
and I, Amar Das of Class 9B, are here to speak about our conference.
Do you know why we are gathered here?
Yes, it is a day of importance.
We are grateful to our Lord God Almighty for the sacrificial life of our founders.
Yes, do you know anything about our founders?
Of course, we might have not seen them, but we have heard a lot and learned about them.
Well, Pranjal, have you noticed a stone on the road near our school, which has a plaque staring John L. Dorsey Road?
Yes. Who is Mr. Dorsey? Why is a school called faith it can mean.
Yes, I will take you down the memory lane. Mr. Dorsey was from USA and he came to India in the year 1952. Well, do you know why Mr. Dorsey decided to stay back in India?
One day, while he was going for a walk, he heard the voice of God clearly.
John, don't go.
Instructing him to move away from the particular place.
John, stop. Turn and run immediately.
Yes, it was a landslide.
Mr. Dorsey thought that it was Lord God Almighty who saved him and wanted him to serve in India. Mr. and Mrs. Dorsey started a ministry in Connaught and they prayed for God's clear guidance.
When they kept the map in front of them and prayed, it was East Patel Nagar that was shown to them.
After hearing the voice of the Lord, Mr. Dorsey and Mrs. Dorsey moved to East Patel Nagar and rented a house and started a prayer meeting.
Mr. Persis Massey suggested to start an English medium school.
Mr. Massey and Mrs. Massey donated ₹3,000 for the starting of the school.
Likewise, six of their friends, Mr. and Mrs. Dorsey, Mr. and Mrs. L. Jeffroy, Mr. and Mrs. Strong, Miss Estelal gave money and trusting God completely and having faith on the Lord Jesus, the school was started on 8th of January 1964. That is why a school is called Faith Academy.
Mr. and Mrs. Dorsey sold everything in America and came to India and settled down in a rented house. It was very difficult for them.
But they did not give up. They continued in prayer and the school took its shape.
Well, let me give you a few examples of Mr. Dorsey. He always rode a bicycle. He did not have enough space to stretch out his body and he was not able to buy a new cot. So, he joined two tin boxes and spread a sheet over them and he used to sleep. Let me tell you one more incident. He was very punctual. He wanted everyone to be punctual. He never went late, even for weddings. If the bridal party was late, he would leave the place.
Being a foreigner, he wanted to eat non-vegetarian items, but the sacrificial Mr. Dorsey used to spend only 15 rupees to buy kebabs. He was able to control the expenses.
Well, can I tell you one interesting incident? Once, Mr. Dorsey was walking on the road. It was day before Holi. Yes, in front of him, two small girls were walking. And behind them, Mr. Dorsey was walking at a distance. And all of a sudden, the two girls were hit by a water balloon. The two girls screamed in fear. Mr. Dorsey looked at the direction where the water balloon came from.
His eyes fell on a boy from a nearby house, whom he quickly recognized that he was a student of Faith Academy.
Mr. Dorsey's eyes burnt in anger. He went straight to the house. Seeing Mr. Dorsey, the boy tried to run. But he held the collar of the boy. And seeing Mr. Dorsey, his parents came running at their doorstep. And realizing what had happened, they apologized to Mr. Dorsey.
Mr. Dorsey stopped and said to the boy, "What you did was wrong. You cannot throw things at people. Those who walk peacefully on the road. Go and apologize to the small girls." Mr. Dorsey told that we are not supposed to abuse or throw anything or bully any of his schoolmates or classmates as we are created in the image of God. Do you know why more incident happened to Mr. Dorsey? One day, while he was walking in the corridor, he noticed a window stopper was bent by some of the students. When Mr. Dorsey saw that, he stood still and stared at that bent window stopper. Tears rolled down his eyes. He recalled his struggles to build the school. Pleading, borrowing and taking loans from the bank, he felt very sad.
So my dear friends, let me ask you one thing. What are the values we learned from the life of Mr. Dorsey? First and foremost is be punctual.
He was punctual. He respected everyone's time.
Remember I told you about the wedding incident? Dear friends, are we punctual? Do we come to school on time?
he led a simple life. Remember, I told you about kebabs?
Well, my dear friends, do we force our parents to buy costly shoes, branded clothes, and expensive electronic devices?
Mr. Dawson took care of the school properties.
Remember, I told you about the window stopper incident? Do we take care of our school? Do we break things? Do we scribble on the wall? Do we keep our school neat and clean?
Mr. Dawson was particular that no one should insult or abuse anybody.
Well, remember I told you about the bully incident? Yes, do we insult and bully others?
So, my friends, these great values made him stand taller. Do you know Mr. Dawson's favorite memory verse?
Yes, can we say it together?
Yes.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Well, we have only talked about Mr. Dawson. What about Mrs. Dawson?
She insisted on two things: neat wear first in writing and to speak only English. Do we write in fair first in writing in our notebooks? Do we speak in English at school?
So, my dear friends, let us enter the new year with these resolutions. Be punctual, lead a simple life, take care of the school, do not bully or abuse anybody, speak in English, and practice well posture and writing. Well, do you know the last message of Mr. Dawson on Wednesday morning assembly?
Yes, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and dine with him, and he with me. Revelation 3:20.
Thank you, Pranjal and Amar. Your words resonated deeply with all of us, and the documentary provided a powerful visual presentation of God's faithfulness to us. Aksha, do you remember all the teachers who have taught you till now?
Yes, of course.
Let me take a quiz. Who were your teachers in the primary section?
Well, to begin with...
Wait, before you begin, let me call upon our dedicated and talented primary teachers as they present an action-packed song that will not only entertain, but also showcase their enthusiasm and creativity.
Let's give a warm welcome as they present an unforgettable action song. teachers. Rakim, do you know why today is so important?
No. But if you fast forward the dates, maybe I can tell you why 25th December is important.
No, let me tell you that 21st December is celebrated as Amy Haggerton Day. On this 21st day of December, we pay tribute to a remarkable individual as her story unfolds that captures the essence of her in life, her kindness, and the reasons we celebrate this day in her honor. So, without further delay, let me invite the students to come over and may the spirit of this day fill us with warmth and inspiration. As the lights dim and the air fills with the spirit of the season, we, the students of middle school, are about to unwrap the gift of a heartwarming Christmas day. May this fill your hearts with joy, love, and the true magic of Christmas.
As Amy Haggerton rounded the corner across the hall from her classroom, she collided with her classmates coming from the opposite direction.
What did you, clumsy girl?
I'm so sorry.
I wonder why she walks like this.
But at the end of the day, Amy was still thinking about the tall boy's teasing. It seemed that ever since Amy started the third grade, someone teased her every single day. Kids teased her about her speech or her limping. Amy was tired of it.
That evening, Amy was quiet. Her mother knew that things were not going well at school. That's why Amy's mom was happy to have some exciting news to share with the daughters.
Girls, I have an announcement. Wish contest on the radio station. It is write a letter to God and you might win a prize. I think someone at this table should enter. What do you say, Matt?
Yes, I think so.
Amy, I think you should take part in it.
Really?
Isn't it, Mummy?
Yes, you can.
In her excitement, Amy rushed to her room to write the letter.
Mom, Dad, what do you think Amy will wish for?
Well, dear, I think a 3-foot Barbie doll would top Amy's list.
A Barbie doll. So beautiful, so elegant.
So, I think she wished for something big, like a MacBook.
But Amy wasn't ready to reveal her secret Christmas gift. She started writing a letter and it went like,
Dear God, my name is Amy. I'm 9 years old. I have a problem at school. Can you help me? God? Kids laugh at me because of the way I walk and run and talk. I just wanted true friends who accept me as I am. Love? Amy.
While Amy's family members are talking amongst themselves, Amy secretly wishes for a miracle. At the radio station in Fort Wayne, Indiana, let us pour in for the Christmas wish contest. The manager had fun reading about all the different letters. When he saw Amy's letter, he read it very carefully and seriously.
Oh, this girl seems to be suffering from a muscle disorder, and the schoolmates of her don't understand her life. How sad. It would be good for the people in Fort Wayne to hear about this special third grader and her unusual wish. Now that's our winner. Let me call up the local newspaper and see what can be done. Hello?
The next day, a picture of Amy and a letter to God made the front page of the Times. The story of a little girl who asked for such a simple yet remarkable Christmas gift. One true friend.
During that unforgettable Christmas season, over 2,000 people from all over the world sent Amy letters of friendship and support. Amy and her family read every single one. But one letter was a very special letter.
Mom, did you see this letter? It talks about one true friend, Jesus Christ. Who is Jesus Christ, Mommy?
Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Come with me as we see the story of the birth of Jesus Christ.
Over 2,000 years ago, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary, who was pledged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph.
Greetings, Mary. You are highly favored, and the Lord is with you.
What do you want? Why have you come to see me?
Do not be afraid. You have found favor with God, and behold, you will conceive and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus.
How is that possible?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the one to be born will be called the Son of God.
Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word.
Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. The angel of the Lord appeared to him and said,
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit.
I must find Mary and do just as the angel said.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. Everyone was required to go to their hometown to register. So Joseph took Mary, who was great with child, on a hard journey to Bethlehem to register.
Yeah.
they looked for a place to stay.
What do you want?
Sir, do you have any room for us to stay?
There are no rooms left. Can't you see how crowded the city is?
Please, please help us.
Okay. There is a stable nearby. You can stay there.
A stable?
It's okay, Mary. The Lord will provide, and you and the baby will be out of cold. Thank you, sir.
Oh,
Christmas. After the wise men had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and told him to escape to Egypt.
Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man.
Well, my dear girls, now you see, Christmas is a season of love, which marks the arrival of God's presence on earth as a baby. It is about how He came to give us love, hope, and joy. Amy, the love that you received through these letters may pass away, but God's love is everlasting and can carry you through any situation, and any form of hurt or teasing can't make you feel lonely again.
Yes, Mommy.
It doesn't matter how hard or hopeless our situation may appear to be. We don't have to journey through our challenges and struggles alone. God is there for us. We are never alone.
So this Christmas, God desires from us a heart for connection, centered on love, compassion, generosity, and kindness in our interactions with others.
As this little girl who dared to wish to have someone accept her as she is, do you all dare to wish to have someone in your lives too?
If yes, Jesus is the answer for the world today. About Him, there's no other. Jesus is the way. If you have some questions in the corner of your mind and peace you cannot find, there's one thing I know for sure, that Jesus is the answer for the world today.
Continuing with the celebration of love and joy, let me now call upon the dancing stars to come and dazzle us with their moves.
Our Lord Jesus' birth, which removed darkness from this world.
heard your words of keeping God first has touched our hearts and deepened the fire of this festive season. Isn't it tremendous how the world comes alive when music fills the air and feet begin to down a rhythm that delights the heart? That's the beauty of dance that we are about to experience now.
Thank you.
Now we have reached the conclusion of our Christmas celebration. I would now like to invite Kanak Prabhu from 9th grade to propose the vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all present here. Feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present but not giving it. A warm thank you always speaks to everyone's heart. So here I am to propose the vote of thanks. I would now like to begin by thanking God Almighty for giving us this day to celebrate. I take this honor to extend my gratitude to all the dignitaries for gracing this occasion with their presence. I would also like to thank our respected heads for their constant support and guidance. Our teachers, who have patiently worked behind the scenes to put up such a wonderful performance. Well, not to forget our participants who enthusiastically participate with all their energy and gusto. Lastly, I would like to thank the wonderful audience without whom this event would not be a roaring success. Thank you.
Behold, the virgin shall be with child and shall bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. With this promise, we now bring this wonderful Christmas program to a close. Let us carry the warmth and joy of this festive season in our hearts. Wishing you all a Merry Christmas and a joyous New Year. Thank you once again for being a part of this special celebration.